Hi everyone, Amber here, owner and head trainer at Summit Dog Training, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to utilize intake forms in Acuity Scheduling to get exactly the information that you need from your client in order to do your job, do your service that you're offering the client without having to chase the client down, without having to spend extra time on the phone or emailing to get that information. Intake forms are really valuable tool that Acuity provides to us and that saves us so much back and forth time and keeps all of their client information stored conveniently in one place for future use. Don't forget to click subscribe below so that you can stay up to date and catch all of our future videos on Acuity, on other dog business topics, and other dog topics in general. We use intake forms in Acuity for everything from letting clients know more about the specifics of the class that they're trying to enroll in, to collecting their dog's behavioral and medical history prior to their appointment, to getting client consent on our policy. Policies and waivers before they arrive for their appointment. Intake forms help us do all of that. They're also highly customizable so that you can get exactly the information that you're looking for that's relevant to you and your services without having to hound the client or really, kind of be in the dark about the information going into the appointment. You can have everything in one place ahead of time. So today I'm going to show you three different sample forms that we use. One is pre-service information form, so giving the client additional information about the service in addition to what they might get from a class description. The second type of form is a client questionnaire, where we might collect information about the client or the client's pet or dog prior to their service. And then the third type of form is a policy consent form, where we ask the client to acknowledge or agree to different terms and conditions of scheduling their appointment with us. All right, let's take a look.
So the first type would be our pre-service information forms. You'll find intake form questions on the left-hand side under third down under availability and appointment types. So for our pre-service information forms, here is an example that of what this looks like for us. And this is a class description, a little bit longer than what we could fit in the service description that a client might see before they schedule, as well as a list of the prerequisite requirements for this type of class. So we list the things that make a student a good candidate for this class, and include at the bottom, if they have any questions, a place to reach us, and then we ask them to consent and acknowledge that they have read the prerequisite and to the best of their knowledge and ability feel like their dog meets these descriptions. On this class description and prerequisite for Reactive Dog 101, we add some additional screening questions. We don't do that for every class, but this class being a particularly a unique class in the type of dogs that we're targeting as far as students in that class, we ask some additional questions to help us make sure and verify that people are getting signed up for the right service. So that is a pre-service information form. No, this form, including this form on the appointment types, does not preclude people from misjudging their dog's ability or misreading the requirements, but it does give us a starting point to have a conversation with a client if we feel like they may have ended up in the wrong class later on. Okay, the next type of form that I want to show you is a client questionnaire. This is where we collect all of the information about the client and their dogs. We split our client questionnaire up into two main forms. One that we request the client to fill out every time that they schedule with us, and that is the dog's info form, including the dog's name, breed, age, food allergies, primary veterinarian, really pertinent information that might have changed since the last time the dog was scheduled with us. And so that's all of these appointment or all of these info boxes are marked as required. So every time a student schedules, they will be asked to fill out this information again. Then our second client questionnaire form is something we call new client information. And we have this marked. We have a little description up at the top that says if you have already, if you're a repeat student and nothing significant has changed since your last visit, you can leave this section blank. So we don't make any of these things required, but this description has a pretty good success rate of encouraging students who are not repeat students, are new students, to complete this form. So this is where we would ask for things like training goals, dogs' reaction to people and other dogs, all of the relevant information that helps us perform the best service for that client. What is the one piece of information that you need from your clients in order to do your job most effectively? For us, it's insight into the client's behavior goals for their dogs. Why are they bringing them to a training class or to a private lesson? But what is that for you? Comment below and share your thoughts on what this looks like for your business. I'd love to know. All right, the last type of forms that I'm going to show you examples of today is a policy consent form. We have several of these depending on the type of service that's being scheduled. And the most important for us, I would say, is our cancellation policy. So I'm going to scroll down here to our policy section and show you our example cancellation policy here. We spell out this cancellation policy in detail. Let me see. I don't know if I can even get it on one screen here. In detail on our website, on the enrollment form where the client is scheduling, as well as we reference this in all of our client emails that are being followed up upon enrollment so that it's very accessible to each and every client who schedules with us. We also have this checkbox here, checking the box, acknowledging that you understand this cancellation policy, and this is required for them to hit enroll at the end. They have to acknowledge this policy. You know, if they don't read it, that's on them, but they do have to acknowledge this policy. So once you've created your sample intake form, you can choose which appointment types it is assigned to. So one way to do that is to go into the intake form itself, and then down on the side, you can select, you know, which appointment types you would like it to be, it to show up on the enrollment for. And then you're going to want to scroll all the way down. Forgive me for my long list of services here. Scroll all the way down and hit save form if you make a change. Then the second way you can do this is through the appointment types itself. So if you go into a certain appointment type, you can then select which forms you would like to show up with that type of service. Intake forms can evolve and grow as your business does. I would start with a few essentials, and then if you find yourself needing additional information or policy approval from your clients prior to them scheduling with you or booking with you, add those onto your intake form library as you go along. To learn more about setting up Acuity for your pet business, I've created a 10-part checklist for your guide to getting started with Acuity. You can grab that for free below. The link is in the description. I hope it's helpful in launching Acuity for your business. I know we at Summit have found Acuity to be a really, really big benefit in launching and scaling our business to help the most people in the most efficient way possible. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, give this video a thumbs up, and check out some of our other videos on our channel as well. And we look forward to seeing you next time.